Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Welcome back to Sunday morning and the old cookbook show. Today, we're not really working from an old cookbook. This is a supplement that used to be very common in weekend newspapers. And this one is from the Brooklyn Daily Eagle. Most of the front cover is missing, but it's a book of cookery and household manual. And this was published in 1927 by the Brooklyn Daily Eagle, a newspaper. And I find these very interesting because the recipes are driven by the advertising that you find in the pages in this book. So, you know, in certain sections, you'll see cookware that is used to cook the dishes that you're cooking, or ingredients that are used to cook the dishes that you're cooking. We're going to do something called a solid chocolate cake. And the full page ad on the other side is for the Wright Cake Company cakes. So if you didn't want to make your own cake, you could pop down to their store and buy one already made. So this is called a solid chocolate cake. And I don't know exactly what they mean by solid. Is it going to be really dense? I kind of think it might be based on the ingredients, but who knows? Or is it a solid cake? Like, is this going to be an amazing cake? So we're going to start off with milk and dark chocolate in a pot on the stovetop. And it calls for a half a cup of dark chocolate. So I've got this really dark chocolate that I've broken up. I'm gonna put it in there and get it melting. And yes, I hear you. You live in a European metric country and you have no clue why Canada and the United States still use volume measurements for a lot of what we cook and bake. Yes, weights would be so much more accurate. But we get by, and even Canada now is a metric country, but we still use volume for everything. We just use metric volume. Instead of using grams, we use milliliters, which is a volume measurement. So half a cup of chocolate. Almost impossible to tell what they meant by that. It could be a half a cup of chopped chocolate. So you would actually be getting more chocolate. It could be a half a cup of chocolate chunks like I just put in. I take that to mean that the amount of chocolate isn't super important, and that if you like chocolate, use a little bit of extra. So I've got, and I weighed it, 150 grams of chocolate in there, and that's what we're going to do. Now, next up, it tells me to cream half a cup of shortening. You're going to notice this is butter. And in this time period, pretty much any time pre-World War II, when you see a recipe that calls for shortening, shortening in that time period meant any fat that was solid at room temperature. In fact, shortening still means any fat solid at room temperature. But the way that the English language works and the way that we shorten things and the way that we try to, you know, save time in printing, shortening has come to mean the shorthand for vegetable shortening. And so a lot of recipes that you see today, when they ask for shortening or in the recipe, they're actually asking for vegetable shortening. In this time period, it could have been anything. It could have been butter, it could have been lard, it could have been beef fat. To a smaller extent, it could have been chicken fat. Probably not so much for chocolate cake. And this book makes reference to that in other recipes where it says to use a really good shortening like butter. So it could be anything. And when you see these older recipes, if it calls for shortening, it could be lard or butter. And I know that a lot of celebrity chefs in the time period that we're in today wax on and on and on about, you know, the water content of shortening, and that if you're using butter, you need to use a little bit more or a little bit less than if you were using vegetable shortening or if you were using lard. And yes, that's true. Different solid fats do have different moisture contents. There's different moisture content in butter than there is in lard or beef fat or vegetable shortening. But the reality is you're cooking at home and you just mismeasured the milk that you put in there. You have mismeasured the flour, at least I know that I have. So all of these different mismeasurements are probably more important than the liquid content of your fat. liquid content of your fat in a small recipe like this really isn't going to make that big of a difference. Now to the butter, we're going to add some sugar and we're going to cream that together. And don't forget about the chocolate melting in the milk. Give it a bit of a stir. You don't want this to come to a boil. You don't want to get it that hot. You just want to get it warm enough that it melts the chocolate, and we're there. So I'm going to turn that off and I'm going to set it aside and let it cool down a little bit, just like if we were making a brownie. This is very close to a brownie. Now the recipe tells me to put in 3 eggs, sorta. So I'm going to put in 1 whole egg. And then the next 2 eggs, I'm going to separate out the whites and keep them for the icing, and only put the yolk in the cake. Now I've got flour here, and this is baking soda, and we're just going to mix that together. I've got a spoon, and I also need sour milk. So in this time period, sour milk meant quite literally milk that's been sour, and in these recipes you'll see them refer to sour milk, you'll see them refer to sweet milk, and you'll see them refer to buttermilk. And depending on the time period, they are 3 different things. The sweet milk is just milk. We would just refer that today to as milk. It has nothing to do with sugar or added sugar in it. A lot of people get it confused with the idea that it is condensed sweetened milk. It's not, it's just regular milk. I'm using buttermilk. Because buttermilk today in the grocery store, at least here in Canada and the United States, is just soured milk. It is exactly the same thing as the soured milk that they were asking for in this recipe. And buttermilk, depending on the time period, can mean a whole bunch of different things. That is one of those word phrases that the more research I do, it becomes more confusing, because it refers to so many different things. It can refer to sour milk in the context of today, but also in the context of 100 years ago, it could mean soured milk that they were then going to churn into butter. So like a European cultured butter. So the butter is cultured or soured first and then churned, and you take the butter and it's got a really nice flavor. It could also mean the liquid that's left over from churning butter, which is a very clear liquid. It doesn't have any milk solids or fats left in it because they've all come out in the butter. And that was used for baking as well. So it could mean a whole bunch of different things depending on which recipe writer was writing about it. But for the most part, at this point, if you see buttermilk, you're just getting cultured butter. It's a 1% milk that has some added bacterial culture and it's left to ferment. So I need to alternate between the buttermilk, the flour and soda. And I'll turn that down just to stir. And the melted chocolate and milk. Just a little bit at a time and let it all incorporate. A little bit of buttermilk. And a little bit of chocolate. Now the recipe implies that you bake this in multiple tins and create a layer cake. So I've got 2 8-inch cake pans that I have greased just as per instructions. I was thinking that a 7-inch cake pan would have been a better idea. We'll get them in the oven and we'll see what happens. And so obviously I'm trying to split the batter evenly between the 2 cake tins. We'll see how that goes. Now the recipe tells me to bake it in an oven set to 375 degrees, so in they go. So it gives me a baking temperature, but it doesn't give me a baking time, so I'm going to keep a really close eye on those so that they don't overbake. In the meantime, let's give this a go. Oh, that's really chocolatey. This is going to be a good cake. The cakes are out and cooling. The recipe tells me to put together with emergency frosting. And it told me to keep out 2 egg whites to use in the emergency frosting. But you go down to the emergency frosting recipe right below it, and it says to use only 1 egg white. Is that a mistake in the recipes? I don't know. I'm going to use both because the one recipe told me to keep both out, so I'm going to go ahead and use both. It says to put it into a double boiler. It says to use 7/8 of a cup of sugar, so I'm going to put that in, and 3 tablespoons of water. Now, the recipe says I can flavor with any desired flavoring, but equal parts of lemon, vanilla, and almond make an excellent flavoring. So, I don't know how much. I'm going to put probably 1/2 teaspoon of each, because that seems like an awful lot. And now I go to town with an egg beater. The only real instruction at this point is to beat it until it's the consistency to spread. And we haven't reached that yet. So I'll just keep beating it until it's there. Okay, let's see. That looks just about spreadable. Now, if you've watched this channel for any amount of time, you'll know that I ice cakes. I do put icing on cakes, but I don't ice cakes. So there's no artful putting icing on a cake for me. I don't really spend a whole lot of time. I just kind of get the icing on and I'm happy with it. So we're gonna put this together. A little bit worried about the emergency frosting. I know that it's just a riff on cooked meringue icing, but the flavors seem a little weird to me to be putting together, and I know that they probably don't go extremely well with a chocolate cake. I know that fully. I was just intrigued by an icing that would have those 3 flavorings in it. We'll see how it tastes when Julie gets here.
Hey, Glen.
Hey, Jules.
Hey, friends. Hey, nice cake. That's an odd textured frosting.
Odd texture frosting. It is an emergency frosting.
Well, then I'll take it. Were we having a frosting emergency
apparently,
today?
Apparently. And this is the...
Some frosting right now.
This is the frosting that they say goes with the solid chocolate cake. So I guess let's just cut into it and see what happens. The frosting had a really weird texture when I was making it. It's kind of like a boiled frosting, but it's not, because you don't boil the sugar syrup, you don't get the same reaction with the eggs as you would with a boiled, and so it's got this kind of weird...
Well, you know, no one says that it is necessarily a bad thing. So now that we've cut it off, I'm curious about the texture. I so need to just, you know, does it... It's funny because it's got a texture like meringue.
It does have a texture like meringue.
It's got like a lemony flavor too.
Yeah, it does. So it's going on a chocolate cake, and it says that, you know, you should put any desired flavoring, but equal parts lemon, vanilla, and almond taste really good.
Okay, so I didn't catch the almond. The lemon dominated for my initial flavor, but let's stop.
So I thought I'll put them all in and see if it works, but I don't know if it'll work with chocolate cake.
The chocolate is so dominant that you don't really notice the...
Oh, that's a pretty good chocolate cake. It's a solid chocolate cake.
Mm-hmm. I was actually thinking because it was called solid, it would be more dense, like a cakey brownie, like a thick.
A little more dense. I also wonder if it's a solid chocolate cake because you use an actual chocolate that you melt rather than cocoa. So it's not flavored with cocoa.
I'm clearly not bothered by the cake because I keep wanting to have more. So clearly it's a pretty decent cake.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know that I need emergency frosting, but...
I don't think I'd use that frosting again.
No.
No, I think a chocolate frosting, a butter-based frosting, would be much more to my liking.
I'm having a hard time now.
But overall, as an experiment, I think the cake is pretty good. I would probably, I cooked it in an 8-inch pan. I think it would probably be better in a 7 or a 6-inch pan.
A little thicker.
A little, give it a little more loft. That's my own personal bias. I think it would bake better. I think it would be nicer. But.
Well, that's the best part. Then you just do version 2.
I think it works. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.